I'll see you later. Thanks.
What are you doing? You're leaving your car?
Watch, it's the car for me. It's easier than leaving it at a garage and waiting. It's a lot quicker that way. You know what I mean?
A one-er is a long take with no cut. The camera follows an extended sequence of events, repositioning and reframing as the actors move within the scene, continuously finding the best point of view for each film moment.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Copacabana is proud to present the king of the one-liners, Henny Youngman.
A big one-er is like a Rube Goldberg machine. Part of the fun is seeing how long you can make it go.
How are you all? I'm glad to be here. Take my wife, please.
I have no talent at all.
A one-er involves a kind
but
of choreography
rat,
between the
actors
and the camera.
He's the one behind these recipes. He's the cook. The real cook. He's been hiding under my toque. He's been controlling my actions. He's the reason I can cook the food that's exciting everyone.
The As the characters move, the camera
door.
Adjusts its position to find the best framing. Each new arrangement of the performers and each new camera position are like new shots,
cook, right?
But without cutting. A one-er isn't just a long take. It implies complexity, moving from framing to framing, from wide to medium to close-up, adjusting camera movement and character blocking to provide the audience with a variety of looks.
Belong here.
Oh, perfect. Well, hi there, I'm a cowboy!
The key to sustaining a one-er, as it is with all shots, is to make sure that the action and the camera movement feel motivated. If the actions of the characters feel spontaneous and natural, and if the camera follows the action without anticipating events, and shows things in as clear and expressive a way as possible, then each framing will feel motivated and the shot can be sustained and will hold the audience's interest. If, on the other hand, the action seems stilted or the camera moves feel forced, the audience will lose interest and will disconnect from the story. A live-action one-er with real actors and real cameras in the real world is a much riskier endeavor than a CG one-er because it actually has to happen in one take and there are so many ways that it can go wrong. Actors can forget their lines, camera operators can lose focus, sound engineers can miss a cue, the sun can go behind a cloud. A live-action one-er is a feat, a high-wire act, a high-stakes wager. It is not for the faint of heart.
Realize I haven't kissed you in over an hour.
So when it comes to executing the shot, the CG one-er isn't really the nail biter that a live action one-er is. But in a way, that just raises the stakes for the CG one-er. If you don't have to worry about mistakes from your actors or technicians, then the only thing keeping a director from creating a long, masterful, extended shot are the limits of his or her resourcefulness. Since the CG world gives a director the freedom to sustain a shot for as long as his or her creativity can generate ideas, you would expect that some directors would try to take full advantage.
Oh no! Again! Come here, my beauty!
In terms of sustained one-ers, I don't think I've seen one that's longer or more complex than this from director Steven Spielberg in Tintin. For duration, inventiveness, and sustained energy, it's hard to beat. To Creating a Wunner requires cleverness and ingenuity. The trick is to smoothly shift from one framing to another without the audience becoming aware that you're linking multiple shot ideas. Big budget visual effects movies mix live action with CG elements. Many of the shots, in fact, are all CG, which makes them no different from a shot in an animated film. In this all-CG Wunner from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, a single shot is sustained across the roof, through the air, and down through the sewer pipes. But I would argue that a Wunner is more about complexity than duration. To me, a simple lateral tracking shot, like this from Rango, or this from the fantastic Mr. Fox, doesn't really qualify as a Wunner, because there's no real variation to the camera work or the staging.
Drag those chickens, slow them down just a little bit, we're a little ahead. Where are the apples? Still now? Do you still have them raw? We'll slice them up.
Play the transmission!
Here's a shot from The Incredibles that's a model of economy. A wide shot, an over-the-shoulder, and an insert. All in 3.9 seconds.
Play the transmission!
In the grammar of film, a Wunner is a compound sentence. In the same way that a compound sentence is a series of sentences strung together with conjunctions and commas, a Wunner is a series of shots strung together with camera moves like the handoff.
Alex Kintner, they're beginning to prune.
Just let me go out a little longer.
Just 10 more minutes.
A handoff is when the camera follows one character and then hands off attention to the next one.
Well, they bring in all I just want to know one simple thing. When do I get to become an Islander?
I know something about love.
In this shot from Strange Magic, we hand off from the fairies in the foreground to the group in the background. Into your blood, go out and get him. And in this night scene from How to Train Your Dragon, we hand off from dragon to dragon and end up on a group of Vikings.
Gronkles are tough. Taking down one of those would definitely get me a girlfriend. A simple back? Exotic. Two heads, twice the status.
They're firing the sheep!
Concentrate fire over the Lord Bank!
In this shot from Ratatouille, we hand off from plate to plate and then from waiter to waiter, ending in a wide shot on the kitchen, with the purpose of familiarizing the audience with the geography of the set. And in this extended shot from Despicable Me, the camera follows the movement of the minions, handing off from one group to the next. With a handoff there. And another one there. And there. And with a wipe there, leading to a wide shot with Gru in the background.
Hey, Snog! Thanks for getting
another
back.
Motivated way of switching from one notice, subject to the next is on the look.
What are these?
When the character in frame looks off screen, a pan to see what she's looking at feels totally natural and allows the filmmaker to switch smoothly to a new subject.
Take that off before somebody sees you.
But you're packing one just like it. Are you hiding something?
Oh, please, honey. I'm on the
yours!
Dash!
This is yours.
It's specially made. What's going on?
You're not coming, and I'm gonna pack!
This shot from Rango motivates the first transition with a handoff. And the second one with a look. But Wunners don't always shift from subject to subject, Sometimes a wonder is all about following a single subject as it travels through the world.
Young lady, forgive me. I believe I have neglected to punch your ticket.
A one-er gives unity to a sequence of actions. Things that would be broken apart with cuts are seen as a single, continuous event, a single idea.
Come on, bring some food over here. We're starving.
The audience may not be consciously aware that they are looking at a continuous uncut shot, but subliminally, they feel the unifying effect. Oh, and another thing? Wonders are fun. And for sheer exuberance and mad creativity, this one, from the Penguins of Madagascar, is in a class by itself.
Okay, Kowalski, your turn to pick up the slack.
Why don't we catch that plane?
Bird strike, log it.
With a long one-er, it's like holding your breath. How long is this thing going to go on?
Follow me, boys. We're going in hot. No one likes to show off, Private.
Aim for first class.
Of course, the longer it goes on, the harder it is to stay.
Kowalski, where does this aircraft go?
From the odd shape of this bagel, I'd say we're headed for Paris.
France? The trick is to be able to stage and shoot the action in such a way that there's never any dead time. There's never a moment when the action and the camera work doesn't feel vital.
Bingo! There's our ride, boys. Can't stay, dog.
Danger is my mistress.
Ah! Rico, more height!
Every camera move must be motivated. The transitions need to be totally seamless, natural, and effortless.
Stay on target!
We're gonna catch it! We're gonna catch it!
Rocky! We're not gonna catch it!
Where's Skipper?
Time to get creative. Start grabbing boxes, boys! Oh, Private, stop playing with those backpacks. Find something useful. Now we're talking.
Nothing should feel forced. Each camera angle should be right for the story moment, and it should all feel alive.
118 yards. 109 yards.
Yes, that was a cut.
Okay, then. It's clear what we need to do next.
Still the one I wanna talk to.